Hello, and welcome to a brand new How to Cosplay episode. I know I haven't done one of these in a few months, but at the same time, I'm going to get back into the swing of it. So, what better way to start than by covering the festive outfits? So, last week I did a video all about the festive outfits themselves, going in a little bit in depth into talking about them, but this time I'm going to show you how to achieve the looks for yourself. So, starting from the Christmas invasion, going all the way up to the Revolution of the Daleks, we'll be covering the most, I would consider, unique Christmas costumes of the Doctor. And New Year, of course. As you've probably noticed, I'm in a little bit more of a compact setup today, due to the fact that my tripod has decided to break. So I just retrieve that there. Look. That didn't happen. So anyway, we're going to talk about the costumes now, so without further ado, let's get to it. Naturally, this video is a connective sequel of sorts to my previous video, in which I talked more about the festive outfits in an in-depth fashion. For this episode, this is strictly talking about how to achieve the looks for yourselves, but do feel free to check out that prior video as well. Anyway, the first one we're going to talk about is the 10th Doctor's Christmas invasion gear, and by that I of course mean his lovely pyjamas that we saw him involuntarily wear. Thank you, Jackie Tyler, for that. The Doctor wears a navy blue dressing gown to start with. Now, this isn't exactly uncommon. You can generally find one of these on Amazon, but the dressing gown does have piping of sorts to it, which is most uncommon. So the one I found closest was this. I mean, it really does look the part, but of course Amazon has an assortment of blue dressing gowns, so feel free to pick your fancy. The pyjamas are much less easy to find, mind you, especially in the specific colourway that you may have to compromise in this particular aspect. Fortunately, with striped or stripy pyjamas being the key term here, and I mean cert term, it won't be too difficult to find ones that fit the vibe, if not being totally exact. Sometimes making do will have to be the key here. But that's not to say you can't get close. Again, Amazon has some good ones, but feel free to check other retailers at your leisure. Also, slippers are a must. You almost definitely have some slippers at home. If not, any department store or appropriate website thereof will have some. Moving on to Voyage of the Damned now, with the 10th Doctor again in a much simpler outfit. And yet, this simple outfit still turns out to be a tuxedo. I know. Still, we can wrap this one up pretty quick. All you need is a black suit. Now, you can usually get this from any store that has a formal wear department. It's the bread and butter of suits, to be fair. This one here is just an example from H&M. Furthermore to that, you'll need the suitable right textured tuxedo shirt, which you can get from Dobell. After that, you also need to grab some standard black trousers, which I'm very sure you no doubt already have a pair of, so we can move on from that. So let's focus on the last two bits, the black bow tie. Again, this is a simple find. Just grab one from H&M or, well, anywhere. And last but not least, we have the Converse high tops, the most egregious part of the outfit. It is very nice. The Doctor wears his black ones with a tuxedo, so therefore you can grab them from the official retailer. A timeless style that is still going strong all these years later. Moving on to the 11th Doctor, and to what I maintain is the most Christmassy outfit of all. His Victorian vibe from Time of the Doctor, and of course, the snowman. Starting with the main centerpiece, that is the coat, there is a simply fabulous cosplay replica that you can get from Cosdaddy. I have used this one myself in the past, so I can attest that it is indeed very good. And rather iconic despite the ensemble only being used in two episodes, Matt still looks amazing in the real deal. With that, you have the option of getting the race coat or not. I say or not because the Doctor does wear it without a race coat midway through Time of the Doctor when he gets older on Trenzalore, but if you want to do the true full ensemble, then grab the black velvet race coat from Obsidian Clothing on eBay. It's a very good interpretation of the one seen on screen. Now the trousers will be tricky. Matt wears houndstooth trousers with these and I struggle to find any suitable alternatives, so my best advice is to get brown trousers or even brown plaid trousers. They will work the best in my humble opinion. The shoes as well, just get brown brogues if you can. Moving on to the shirt, the Doctor wears a striped shirt, not too dissimilar from his scroll striped shirts of Series 5. For this, I recommend just any shirt that has thin reddish stripes on it, or you could attempt to paint the lines on via fabric paint or a pencil. But this of course is an emergency suggestion. Failing that, a regular white or light beige shirt will work. And of course, there is the bow tie. My personal favourite bow tie, and naturally it's available from Mrs. Bowtie.
It's quite popular though, so you may have to wait for it to restock, but it is pretty. Now, with the Trendsel all looks covered, let's move on to the 12th Doctor and his own unique look for the holiday season. Now, for the Twice Upon a Time look, I'm pretty sure that most of us don't necessarily have the, finances or even the audacity to cut up a £2,000 navy velvet coat. So here's one that I made with my old Cos Daddy coat. The coat in question is the standard navy Crombie wool coat, but with the bright red lining that it has, it makes an ideal test subject to see if I can convey the actual look. But feel free to obliterate a coat that you feel would be an adequate substitute. This also doubles as a post-regeneration 13th Doctor look, and currently is the only outfit that she wore on Christmas Day. So, I'll run through the various sections of damage on my interpretation of the coat, and the various methods that I utilised to achieve it. I used a combination of sandpaper and scissors to achieve the battle damage effects here. I used the scissors to make incisions into the wool exterior of the coat, while also separating it from the lining, leaving that to dangle. With these wounds opened, albeit with some needing to be wider, I tore them slightly more and more open with my hands and cut another strip away. You can see that the ends really needed to have that tattered and messed up effect to them for the effect to work. I now had to make them a little bit more unkempt, if only because using scissors can make them look a little bit too clean. So I used sandpaper to distress the fabric around the holes and make them look a little bit more naturally shredded. For the back, go up from the bottom with scissors. Don't go too mad with it though, but go up to round about one third from the bottom upwards with a couple of cuts, and then cut in between them. It's all to make the raggedy effect. This also applies to the sleeves. Open them up a bit so that the lining is always on show above the shirt cuffs. With that in mind, you now have a very fresh coat, but a workable version of a cosplay for the Twice Upon a Time look. For the Woman Who Fell to Earth look, just double down on the damage here. Moving on to the 13th Doctor and her outfit from the 2020 New Year's Day episode, Spyfall. Now, I have covered this look before in my 13th Doctor How to Cosplay episode, but even then, it could do with a minor update. So, here's that Spyfall segment with updated items. It's a deceptively simple outfit to put together, but the main thing is just about piecing it all. So first things first, the coat. Josie wears a long tuxedo overcoat as part of her espionage ensemble. Only problem is, they ain't cheap. The screen accurate one the Doctor wears is roughly 950 quid and from Paul Smith. However, there are alternatives, such as this Prince Edward frock coat. It may not be quite as long and it would need to be ankle long, but it is still pretty long. And it is a cheaper alternative with a similar structure in how it looks and for a massive saving as well. I'm sure you can make it work. The rest of the outfit is actually quite easy to be honest. You just need a white formal shirt that you can get at most clothing stores, black button braces, black socks, the same boots, and one final detail. Bow ties are cool again, and the Doctor's bringing them back for one more spin. For those looking to get it exact, here is the exact style of bow tie that was worn by her in the episodes, made and sold by the original creator. Needless to say, it is 100% screen accurate, and a fantastic piece to have in your collection, let alone wear on your costume. With that said, it would be totally understandable if it wasn't exactly in your price range. I mean, it is quite a pricey piece. So in that case, I would recommend searching for gold paisley bow ties as an alternative, as they would give across the same sophisticated vibe. And finally, to end everything off, let's start by giving you a head start on how to cover the 13th Doctor's Revolution of the Daleks look from the upcoming New Year special. Firstly, you need the prison jumpsuit. And the search term here is red boiler suit, representing the base form of the piece that you're going to use to make the outfit. I found this one here with a wide range of sizes, but feel free to choose any one that you think suits you best. Now to do this, and bear in mind that I am theorizing here, I haven't tried this myself, but this is what I just think that would be the most efficient way to do this. You can sew a long rectangle of black fabric over the left shoulder and sew that into the fabric of the boiler suit, and then fabric paint the alien symbols onto it. Or you can fabric paint the whole section, whatever matches your own vibe. The same applies to the barcode too. You could either get some metallic or shiny copper-esque material and sew some black fabric around it, or you can paint the whole thing again. I mean, as I said, I haven't tried as I don't cosplay 13, But take a look down the tag on Instagram and you'll see a good amount of cosplayers who have put their own spin on this particular outfit, if you need a bit of inspiration. I'm simply here, in this case, to provide a starting point. The last bit of the outfit is the black boots, so any black shoes you have will suffice perfectly. Aside from that, make it your own.
I've just discovered that I can balance my phone on my door handle. Modern technology, folks. Anyway, thank you for watching, and I hope you'll enjoy the rest of How To Cosplay series, which will be coming out early next year, progressively. I'm going to move it to a fortnightly schedule, because that way I'll be able to keep doing it. Sorry it's taken so long to do them. It's just a case of being distracted by nearly everything under the sun. But if there's still a demand for it, then I will make sure it gets done. And as well as that, I just want to say thank you very much for watching me and supporting me throughout 2020. This isn't the last of my 2020 output, of course. Next week, I've got the brand new audio drama short story, The Cult of Christmas, coming out. And that is starring very lovely people. Gareth Heathcott is playing the 12th Doctor. And the lovely Katie Rose, my other half, is playing the companion for that episode, Kyle. So I hope you'll enjoy that. Finally, I just want to wish you all a very Merry Christmas. I know this year has been extremely hard for a lot of us, but I just want to say, here's hoping to next year being better. Make the best of Christmas as you can, and just remember, you're never alone. Take care of yourselves, and until next time, see ya!